Hi, my dear students. Under this presentation, my target is to explain how to develop appropriate, more suitable check sheet to collect relevant, most appropriate data. That means you are going to collect data. First of all, you should have idea. You have to explain what is data collection. What's the meaning of data collection? Therefore, under this scenario, I am going to start this presentation from that point. What it is? I am going to explain what is data collection. Then after that, step by step, we can go and develop appropriate check sheets. Suppose you are going to assess the health of your process. Data collection will help you to assess it. First of all, you have to identify the main key quality characteristics that you are going to measure. It is not enough. Not only that, you should have idea how to collect. After collecting the data, how we are going to analyze it. Exactly key quality characteristics. What are the exactly key quality characteristics? It is the characteristics of the product or service produced by a process that customer have determined it is important to them. Don't forget it. Who is going to determine? The customer is going to determine what are the important elements, what are the important characteristics of the product. Every product or service has multiple key quality characteristics. When you are going to select a process to improve, you need to find out the process and process steps that produce characteristics your customers perceive as important to the product quality. Yes, we can define data collection in a very simple way. Data collection is nothing more than planning for and obtaining useful information. Planning for and obtaining useful information on key quality characteristics produced by your process. However, simply collecting data does not ensure, itself does not ensure that you will obtain the relevant or specific enough data to tell what is occurring in your process. My dear students, the key issue is not how do we collect the data. Rather, it is how do we obtain useful data. The next question is, why do we need to collect data? In every process improvement effort relies on data to provide a factual basis for making decision throughout the PDCA decision making cycle and do check and act cycle. Data collections will support your team to formulate and test working assumptions about your selected process. And in addition to that, it will help to develop information that will lead to the improvement of the key quality characteristics of product or service that is recognized by the customer. That data collection improves your decision making by helping you. It will help you focus on the objective information about what's happening in your process, what's happening in the process, rather than subjective opinions. Dear students, next if you are going to collect data,
we should be develop the data collection
you
plan.
Will need to develop a data collection
data
plan.
Collection you should plan have a data collection the plans
they are going to be BDCA cycle.
You going to collect data
the BDCA cycle.
You are going to develop a plan,
provide a framework
For the elements of beyond understanding the of your process
should be clearly
interpret the data
defined
that will lead to
real process improvement.
For what operational definition?
It can be time consuming.
For what operational definition?
Planning sessions are extremely
operational definition
because
in order to collect useful data.
That is your when your mind.
You establish the guidance that help you to obtain the right data.
In order to collect useful data,
let's section
that three people are collecting data,
but is on the time,
what question should be the data collection performance plan certain process?
Unless
what's
the
exact moment
when each action needs to develop the answers
the exact moment
to the following questions
end.
As for the basis
defined,
for sound
which
data
controller
plan.
Will one, observe and
want
on
the data
on understanding
the purpose
of
it. The data collection
why do
process,
we want data?
The data collection
yes,
process,
now
can
we
not
have collect
standardized,
but it's our next
step.
Step.
But we are going
because
to do with
those
their
things.
Personal
but those are the questions
first of all we have to answer.
You will have collect data
during the plans.
You will
stage,
have collect data.
Your team
but
has to develop working hypothesis.
Is much good for you.
Which will
yes,
serve as a guide
data,
for the future
enough for your purpose.
Those have developed based on the already
data collection
collected data and observations.
Such
data collection
can involve
multiple
flowcharts,
cause and effect
diagrams.
Now you are going to set the assumption
you
for,
your data
for what to develop
plan,
the process.
You should try to
when
eliminate.
The process.
You should try to eliminate
so,
as
therefore under this background,
many subjective
your
choices.
Hypothesis
you have to try
statement
to eliminate
should be started
choices.
As follows.
As much as possible.
It is
by
if
operationally define the parameters.
As an example, shall we take
needed to do
one?
The job correctly.
If we change
it has to be done.
Steps
it
X
may be
in our
as
process,
simple as establishing separate
doing,
criteria.
We believe
and a specific
we will
way
improve
to
why,
which is the key
when
quality characteristic
when
it's
step
of
begins
our
and when it
ends. Your data so collectors
from where
will
we
have a
collect
standard
the data.
Operating
the
procedure
that we are going
they
to collect the data
operating procedure
must be clearly identified
used during the data collection
not easy, but if tackle following things in proper way you can find that answer without any issue. What are those? First one, you have to refer the flow chart which drawn both in the current state of the process as well as the, after modified the situation. Here you have to focus on the steps of the process where are the quality characteristics you are lined to improve in. All you have to focus on the steps of the process. Then after that you have to collect the data from these focus steps. Collect, you must collect data twice. First of all, you collect baseline data before you make any changes in the process. Then you have something to compare with the modified process. Then you must collect the data after the changes, after modification. Now you have two set of data, before the improvement and after the improvement. Then it is very much easy to compare. To translate those into the graphical method, you can use that Pareto chart, Rand chart and histogram. Finally, you have to collect the data set again. At the time that a process over, end of the process, then you have three sets. Before the changes, after the changes, and you can compare both two and you can validate the changes by compare with the output of the process. The next question is what type of data will we collect? In general, data can be classified into two major types. As you know, attribute data and variable data. Attribute data gives you a count representing the presence or absence of the characteristics or defect. These counts are based on the occurrence of discrete event. Suppose if you are concerned with timely delivery of parts by your storekeepers, you should develop a procedure. You should develop a procedure that would give you a count of number of supply plant they deliver on time and number of times they deliver late. This is the one give you through attribute data. But however, there is no chance to find the time late, actual time late from the expected time. The variable data is the second group. The variable data based on the measurements of a key quality characteristic produced by the process, such as measurements. Such measurements might include length, width, time, weight, or temperature. The next question is, how do we collect the right data? Yes, we can collect the data, but the problem is, how can we collect the correct data? Don't forget, what is the purpose of collecting data? We are going to collect the data to improve our process. Based on the data, you are going to measure the performance of the process. Then you have to collect small sample sizes. Collect frequently, each and every day or each and every hour you have to collect it. Depend on the availability of data, cost and consequences. You can't spend more and more for data collection. You have to think about the cost and everything that influences the data collection process. Question is, how do we collect the data? Next question is, how do we collect the data? Many teams struggle with it, but answer is very much simple. You don't want to allocate separate person for data collection. You can ask your process workers to do it. Who have a best opportunity to record the results? They also know the process best and can easily detect the problems occur. Don't forget, it is very much important to train them how to do it, how to record it, and you should provide necessary resources to make it in a correct way. You have to provide time, you have to provide paper, you have to provide pencil and other measurements tools.